Oh, whoa. That title screen is just giving me flashbacks. No kidding about that. Hello, everybody, and welcome to my next Let's Play for the YouTube channel. This will be of Life is Strange Before the Storm. Of course, we have to go into good old story time before we actually get started with the game here. I think it was sometime, first of all, I guess I should start. Life is Strange Before the Storm is actually a prequel to Life is Strange. Life is Strange was one of those games that you kind of is like, whoa, and then everybody's like, whoa, and you play it, and you're like, whoa, and then it ends, and you just can't stop whoa-ing. I don't really know how to explain it too much, but it was a game that blew me away, as I had only really ever experienced these quote-unquote, dialogue-driven, choice-making games with consequences through YouTube videos and various series I used to watch way back in the day. So Life is Strange was kind of my first game that was ever focused on that kind of thing, and I got attached big time. I think I played and did a Let's Play on my channel of Life is Strange sometime over a year ago, I think during like the earlier parts of 2016. I could be wrong, it could have been 2015, but I feel like it was 2016, though it might not have been, you never know. And I just realized, fuck, I didn't edit my graphics settings, so the recording might totally screw up, and this will be just an introduction video. God damn it, why didn't I... Son of a bitch. Anyways, it was one of my more popular Let's Plays in the sense that people love watching. It's a good game to LP because it's interesting to see how somebody else plays the game, what choices they make and how they react to certain situations. And even though the first 6 to 9 hours of the game was screwed for me because my recording software didn't work, I did come back and decide to play and finish the game. And I think Life is Strange is one of the only games that I have. Well, I've basically cried in a lot of my game videos if something really hits me hard, but I think Life is Strange was probably the game I've bawled my eyes out to the most at the end. I mean, I went through with some tears and some shocking moments here and there, but it wasn't until the very end. When I got to the end, for some reason, I just fucking lost it. I couldn't help it. I don't know what got over me, but something about that just totally killed me. But yeah, so we're going to be playing this. So why exactly have I decided to play this? Well, I was talking with somebody on Steam, and it kind of made me change my mind a little bit on wanting to play this. Originally, I didn't want to play this. Oh my god, hella high. That's a graphic setting? This game automatically gets a thumbs up. That is amazing. Holy shit. Okay, hold on. Is this going to screw up my recording? I don't know. I don't know if it's going to screw up my recording, so... Because usually it does. Hello? I don't think it screwed up my recording. Alright, but yes. So the reason that I wasn't getting to this, because I said I picked it up a couple months back, and I said, you know what, we're going to play this when it comes out, and then I didn't. Well, the reason for that was because usually with episodic games like this, I like to wait until all of the content is out and ready to be played. So that I can experience it all in one go. But see, the thing is one of the huge things about these games, right, is that they can be ruined so easily by just one spoiler. And I don't want to risk that, so I said, okay, fine, I will play this game so I can avoid spoilers. Even though I won't be able to play through the entire game in one go, I will be able to play episode 1, then we'll play episode 2 when it comes out, and episode 3 when it comes out, and then the bonus thing when that comes out. I did buy the Digital Deluxe Pre-Order version of the game. That's how much I like it, or loved Life is Strange, so I trusted the pre-order. So I don't know when those are supposed to be out, but we'll just see how it goes. And this is a way for me to avoid spoilers, because a lot of my viewers, are great, but there are there's a few viewers in between there that like to just say, oh, you don't want me to spoil shit? Okay, well, this is what happens here, and make sure you make this decision, otherwise this will happen. And it's like, dude, what the hell? So, you might try and spoil something for me here, but All of this is going to be pre-recorded, bitch, so there's nothing to spoil. And if you spoil something, you're going to get yourself a nice hefty ban from the channel so that you don't spoil it for other people, because I don't like assholes. But without further ado here, the audio might be a little loud, so I'm going to go ahead and break this master volume down just a little bit. We'll see once I actually start getting into the game, but right now it's kind of hurting my ear holes. Subtitle size, normal. I'll just keep that. Video settings, audio subtitles, save files, game settings. Okay, what is game settings? I'll probably have to edit mouse sensitivity once we get in there. This is literally completely blind, obviously, if you couldn't tell that already. And this is my first time loading up the game, so I'm ready. Back. How to play. I know how to play. I've played Life is Strange before. It's been a while. I did try and play it again to get all the achievements, but I got too sad during the introduction sequence and had to stop. Alright, episode. So, okay, here we... Oh, wow. So they actually show us the episodes right off the bat. So we have three total episodes throughout this game, apparently. And episode one, which we will be starting with, is Awake. And then we have Brave New World and Hell is Empty. I don't know if that shit is spoilery there or not, but... Okay, I'm ready. I'm a little scared. I'm just a little bit nervous, but I'm ready. This is something... fuck it. Why does it say purchase Digital Deluxe? I already have it. I think they're just saying that because of the thingy. Why won't it start? I'm clicking on it. Do I have to press enter? Oh. Son of a bitch. That in the background. Or, I don't even know if you could hear me. I just said I'll turn my air conditioner off. Oh, Life is Strange Before the Storm is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of your actions and decisions will impact the world around you. Choose wisely. Oh, great. And we're playing as Chloe Price, if I remember correctly. But I still want to kind of make choices based around my own decisions. I don't want to have to, like, role-play as... What are you doing? There's no way that the train's gonna stop. Oh my god, it doesn't feel right.
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes.
Oh, fuck yes.
Mom
fuck yes
would
indeed.
Kill me if she knew I was out here.
Oh shit, are we playing now? We are. Oh, the mouse sensitivity isn't that bad, actually. I do think I want to crank it up just one tick, though. Let's... Oh yeah, that's a little better there. It's the good... I wish more games would do this. Oh, I say that and then I start having lag issues. I wish more games would do this with their... the smoothness of the mouse movement, where, you know, you can tell... It almost looks like I'm... Actually... It's not easy to move diagonal. It seems like this is a game that's designed to move... Because look, I'm moving my mouse diagonal right now, but it's only moving horizontal and or vertical. It's very hard to get it to do that. That's why it looks glitchy. Because I don't think it's... I think it's meant more for a controller. That's what it feels like. But that's what I wish more games would do, is make them feel more like controllers. Because I'm tired of games having that really pixelated feel when you're using the mouse and shit. Hopefully that's not down too low. My ears hurt. Okay, let's get a move on here. I don't know... Okay, we can walk at a brisk pace here. Fence. Alright, that's right. We gotta interact with stuff. It's been a while, so it might take me a little bit to get used to how this works. Oh, I see.
No trespassing?
Okay.
No way.
Approach the fence, hold down right left mouse, and press S to jump. Of course. Good old Chloe Price. That is her name, right? If I got that wrong, then... I love it. This is great.
Holy shit.
It's pretty badass.
This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
That door right there, yeah, it doesn't look like we've got... Looks like we've got some dingleberry. Holy shit, there's a lot of cars here. That's a truck. Is there anything here I can interact with? Like, do I have to make a distraction? Maybe mess with the machinery right in front of him?
That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
Betting stub.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
What does that say? Merrick? I'm not... I can't read this type of handwriting. Is this Chewer, Goldie? Oh, here we go. Damon Merrick. Stake 1,000, loss 1,000. Amazing. I can't take it with. I don't know if that'll be any use to us. Like, maybe I'll have to remember that information. I gotta really try and pay attention here as much as possible. That music inside, holy crap, it's gonna... who we got here? Arguments.
Those guys need to get a room. Or not.
Whoa.
Damn.
Mind your own business. I understand, really. And it won't ever happen again, I swear.
Some say the world will end in fire.
Or a giant tornado.
Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home. Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home.
Yeah, if I remember correctly, she has a bit of a shitty background here.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
No kidding. What is... Where is something forever? It looks like maybe... Oh, wait. Two wheels forever. Okay.
This place has collected a lot of junk over the years.
Yeah, a dog kennel. It looks like junk. Oh. Maybe that's where I go, but I want to interact with the bike here.
I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print.
New dialogue unlocked. Can I talk to the bouncer? Hey!
I've got to figure out how to get past this guy.
Let's talk to him, see what we can do. And the animation is great.
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Excuse me. I had to sneeze. Well, it said I unlocked new dialogue options from those flower things, but... Like, there's a door here. I'm sure I could sneak in. Oh no, I can listen.
A second door inside? So close, and yet so far.
Oh yeah, it's so unlocked.
This band shreds so hard. I gotta get in there.
It's gonna be loud as hell in there. Doesn't sound like bad music, though, but I don't know, because I didn't really like what she was listening to, and... Ooh! Oh, no, that's just that bike. Okay, something I can help to convince him. Ooh, what is this? Train car.
An old lumber car. Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here.
Of course. Can I use this bedding thing? Will this... Can I pick this up now? No, I can still just only look at it. And I want to ponder, is there something on the other, maybe there's something on the, oh wait, now I'm not just brisking pace. Something over here I can use? Wait. Graffiti.
Ah, perfect place for me to work.
What? Oh no, what are you doing, Chloe?
Now, what to draw?
A penis. Oh my god, I get to pick it? Free candy? That is hilarious. I got an achievement for it.
Hey kids, free candy.
That is hilarious. That is so freaking hilarious. Oh my god, I have a journal. Okay. Shit to tag. Oh, so this is like the pictures you took with Max. In the other Life is Strange. That would explain why I got an achievement. Okay. So what are all these things then? Oh god, she writes in a journal. Damn it, now that means I have to read. And reading's not my forte. Where are we? Oh my god, there's pictures of people and there's a Max. Young Max. Okay, we gotta look through this stuff, because I put hold on everything else. Look, that's episode one, yeah. For the pictures. What is this? Oh, sure. Phone, okay. Let's see. Page one. 2010? Is that what that says? Okay. Dear Max, Jod got me the stationery one day when I... Fuck, there's no way I'm sending this, is there? Chloe the Unfriended. That's exactly something I would write. I would start writing something, and then I'd be like, what the hell am I doing? But I would actually write, what the hell am I doing? I've done that before when I was typing emails. And then I just scrapped the email. After spending about half an hour typing it. Now this is more like it. Here I can write to you all I want without wondering or worrying if you'll ever write me back. Oh, that's sad. That is depressing. Maybe one day when you return home and apologize for having forgotten about me and we kiss and make up, I'll show this to you and we can read it and laugh. We did kiss in the other game. Or maybe I'll decide that Journal Max is way cooler than Reality Max and you'll just live in here forever as my little imaginary former current best friend pen pal. Time will tell. Yeah, you can tell she's pissed, but that's kind of to be expected. I can only imagine. Yeah, it's okay, so... Oh, what happened? I'm trying to remember back to the other game. So we learned that Chloe, she kind of went off the deep end. She went off the deep end already, but she went off the deep end more when Max left town. And then she met someone called... Oh, what the fuck was her name? Rachel or something like that, I think? And that's basically... That was one of the sub-stories we learned about during the other game. And I don't really want to spoil it. Because I don't know, you might not have seen the other game yet. So I'm assuming, I mean, there's no doubt we're going to meet Rachel in this game because she's in the image, the wallpapers and everything for this game, so it's going to be there, it's going to happen. Ready? So Mom suggests taking a road trip next summer, and I'm like, cool, I guess, but then she starts talking about David being there. Yes, that David, the wannabe drill sergeant who swooped in on Mom and has stuck around like a bad zit. Dad, the mustache monster from Planet Dipshit. That fucking David. This is hilarious. This is going to be great. Oh my god. Yeah, okay, so I remember David. Yeah, I remember him. I'm just trying to remember everything. Anyway, I politely suggested to Mom that perhaps it was too early to assume David would be in the picture by then or breathing. Hey, shit happens, as you might imagine. That didn't go over well. Well, no, because you probably didn't politely suggest. You were probably like, what the fuck, Mom? You don't pull this bullshit. But really, if this guy's still around 3 months from now, then she's got serious self-esteem issues, and I've got serious self... What? Emolition. Look it up, nerd. I guess it's a word I don't even know, because I've never even fucking heard that word spelt, so I gotta look it up, nerd. She can do better, that's all I meant, but she didn't want to hear it, like I'm the asshole. Chloe the asshole. Jeez. Again, this is definitely shit I would write. Oh, is that the principal? I'm not even reading it, and I can see that this reminds me of that principal. Remember the drunk or whatever? And that's now bringing back memories to other things that happened at the school. So you know how I stopped going to class so much, like you stopped talking to me so much? Funny story, I had trouble coming up with an excuse, so I just didn't. I just didn't show up, and it was fine. Nobody said anything to me. Crazy, right? It's like I'm invincible all of a sudden. Maybe that's the perk of being a dead dad girl. No one knows what to do with me, so they're actually relieved when I stay home. Wish I'd figure this out sooner. Think of all the wasted school time. P.S. Priz from Blade Runner popped into my head last time I rubbed one. I rubbed one? What kind of terminology is this, like drug term? No, I have no idea. I mean, at first I was thinking about Deckard and that smolder of his, but then Priz. I don't know who the hell fuck she's talking about, but she says Blade Runner. Is she talking about the movie or the game that came out? Just totally stole the show. Probably nothing there. I think I just want her bangs. Chloe the Electric Sheep. Okay, interesting. But yeah, okay, so one other thing I want to mention about this that I can, you know, is actually a personal thing. About writing like this. I don't write like this anymore, but I used to. In fact, over here on my desk, because this desk is old. In fact, I have a bag of Cheetos that I must have forgotten about. That's how little my desk gets searched. And this bag of Cheetos, Flaming Hot Cheetos, expired September 22nd, 2014. It's now almost September 22nd, 2017. So yeah, you can see that there's a lot of things that get on my desk that get lost. But over here on the left side, I have a handful of notebooks. And what I did, I think it was like it was 2013 or 2014 when I started. I guess it was 2013 when I started basically writing my own journal with a notebook. And I would write every day. Every day I would talk about my day and talk about just shit. But sometimes I would write like this, and I can already tell you, if you write like this, you know exactly how it is. Essentially, if you don't understand how this works, is it makes you feel better, kind of. It helps. It's a coping mechanism if it's about something depressing, and I think that's where, you know, that's where Chloe's coming from here. Notice how she writes the first line here is, so you know how I stopped going to class so much, like you stopped talking to me so much. She basically, you know, she's angry at Max and she's bitching to Max, but she's not. She knows that Max isn't going to see it, so she says it in this way, in a book that Max will never see, because she knows it's okay. And then that somewhat makes her cope with it, because she can talk in that kind of way. That's exactly how I am with me. I will say things in the book, either to someone directly or about someone, and I will feel okay about it, but it's something I could never personally tell them. And I'm not necessarily saying that I'm calling them an idiot or a bitch or something, no. I'm talking, it could be anything. Could be personal feelings, could be anger, could be happiness, something I just don't feel comfortable sharing. But you can do that and cope with it in a book that you just can't do person to person. It's quite amazing, actually, how it works. And maybe I should start writing again, because it might help me, you know, push through different shit. So that seems to be everything in her journal right now, or her notebook thing. So let's look at all of our characters here. So we've got Chloe. My name is Chloe Price, so I was right. But you can call me Middle Finger. That's hilarious. I am an inmate at Blackwell Academy, currently serving a 4-year sentence for crimes against maternity. That would be my mom, Joyce, who seems endlessly disappointed in me, which I get it. I'm no one's image of a perfect daughter or student or anything, really. But who the fuck wants to be perfect? I'm surrounded all day by so-called perfection, and it sucks ass. Other things that suck, mom's new drill sergeant boyfriend, David. How hard is it to buy weed around here, having no friends, hypocrites, country music, people who say chillax, dad being dead. Wow, this is some, wow, what the hell is worms? Weird things to doodle. I guess I would have doodled the same exact things, because you can see, and I love how they actually doodle it here, too. Like, these aren't perfect pen lines, they're out of order, and they're squiggly, and they're mixed, and they're, you know, there's some unfinished lines. That's great. That's an attention to detail that I appreciate. It's been 2 years since he died in a car crash, and I still think about him all the time. I've even been having these weirdly lifelike dreams. Sometimes I think he's trying to tell me something. Other times I remember that he's feeding worms in a ditch right now, and anything else is just a fairy tale to make myself feel better. At least I have two weapons to help me survive this shitberg town. The pen I used to tag, and oh, I guess that's what we used out there, tag any and everything I want, and my shining personality. If I work at it, maybe I can leave this place just a little less perfect than when I found it. And oh, I guess, yeah, we move. Is that a... No, okay, I thought... The first thing I thought I saw there was a dick. That's, of course, you can see where my brain is. So now we're on David and Joyce, which are... This would be her mother and basically, I guess, a boyfriend of the mother. Despite my mom's best efforts, I don't actually hate her. I know shit's been rough since Dad died. Money's tight, her job as a waitress at a diner isn't exactly glamorous, and I'm clearly not all about the whole going to school thing. But why does she have to make things so much harder on the both of us? She acts like if I smoke pot, or when I skip out to go catch an awesome show, it's somehow a personal attack on her. She would be happy that I'm self-medicating and not going postal on everyone. Or postal, or postal, I don't exactly know the proper pronunciation. She never used to be this way when Dad was around. She could actually be cool. But lately, there's a hairy dick monster. You've gotta be kidding me. Is that what that picture is supposed to represent? A hairy dick monster? The drill sergeant, because he's got the helmet on and a whip, like he's commanding. He's got, oh, that is hilarious. David Madsen. I think that's how you pronounce that. A jobless, brainless, dickless little shit with a hard-on for the military and a promise to whip me into shape. Asshole. Yeah, see... I've tried to express these concerns to my mom, yet every week it seems the virus spreads to yet another corner of her life. I'm starting to worry that the David flu is just the kind of disease that kills its host. Whoa, I just got an overwhelming taste of... like garlic bread in my mouth. That was weird. I don't know where that came from, but I haven't eaten anything garlic recently. Take a drink of water there, wash that down. Okay, anyways, so I wouldn't like living with that kind of rule either, definitely. A dickless little shit that has a hard-on for the military. Whip me into shape. Crap like that would just drive me insane. But you learn... I don't know, because that might be a minor spoiler. So, you know what? Fuck it, I won't. But if you've played the other game, you know exactly. You know more about it. The whole circumstance. Oh, crap, here we go. This is Max. And I love how the only picture she has is when we last saw each other, I guess. When we were younger. Max Caulfield, MIA, ex-best friend extraordinaire. The artsy motherfucker loves photography more than life itself and definitely more than me. She even uses old instant cameras. It's probably not healthy for anyone to be that stuck in the past, but who am I to tell people how to live their lives? When we were kids, we would dress up like pirates and eat ice cream, and write and draw these stupid comic books where we had powers and saved people and shit. Then my dad died. And her dad got some job up north and she moved away to Seattle. It was probably the moment when I needed her most, and she bailed. Thanks, Max, for teaching me that I can't rely on anyone. I mean it. Life lesson learned. The worst part is that even though we haven't spoken in months, even though she habitually ignored my text so much that I just stopped trying, even though I know deep down that she doesn't care about me anymore, and that she probably has all new friends up in fucking Seattle, I still miss her. If she came back tomorrow and said, "Hey, Chloe, want to dress up like pirates and be stupid together?" I would take her back in a heartbeat. Lub-dub is the noise in a heartbeat. Oh, that's amazing. So she does fucking care. That's what I love. Okay, and here we have, who is this? William. This is her dad, if I remember correctly, isn't it? So... If I had a nickel bag for every jerk-off guidance counselor or therapist who tried to get me to write shit about Dad over the last couple years, I would never have to buy a weed from Frank again. Oh my god, Frank. I remember him. What's the matter? Don't want to write your dear old Dad? I guess they think it helps me cope with my feelings. Wasn't I just talking about this? How writing helps you cope? I guess for some people it doesn't work, but I think for a lot of people it does. It's a good. It might not sound like it because I didn't think it was, but once you actually start writing and you get going, sentence after sentence and soon paragraphs after paragraphs, you lose the track of time, and it's not only that, but I think it's enjoyable. As if a few paragraphs about how great Dad was could help me forget that his guts are probably still plastered to the underside of a semi-truck. That's just great to think about. And what the fuck am I supposed to write anyways? That he was the perfect dad, who was always fun to be around and never angry, that he treated me like an equal, that he was constantly working to make our lives better, that he could always make me laugh even when I was being a bitch, that he sang in the shower and hated hypocrisy, and that his BBQ or barbecue grill is still rusting in the backyard because the thought of either throwing it away or ever using it again are both so painful that it's easier for Mom and me just to pretend neither of us notices it. If that's copying, or if that's coping, then coping can go fuck itself. That's a beautiful little picture there, too. Okay, so that's all the characters we know about. And as for the tagging, we tagged, "Hey, kids, free candy." I like how we actually get to choose what we wanted to do. That's really funny. Hopefully we get to do that more often, because I wonder if that'll have any effect later on. Probably not. It's probably like really minor choices, but it's still fun the way that you get to choose that stuff. Oh, what is this here? Oh! I guess it's things that I found, because I've got one here. The thing I found. So I guess there'll be more. So anything we find on the ground, then we should probably focus on. Whoa, this feels like a weird different game now, because we spend so much time reading. You know, I'm honestly hoping that garlic wasn't me feeling like I was going to throw up. Ooh, what is this?
Seriously, though, who drives an RV to a firewalk show?
This guy, obviously. I guess we gotta stand up to this guy. Unless there's a different way around, but... Well, I can... Oh, shit.
Keep walking, kid.
What? You noticed I was trying to get in? Well, wait, can I...
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Let me inside now, or the mill... Oh, yeah, his bike.
Is that your bike over there?
Yep.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
No, it's got flowers on it. Oh, that's it?
This is the old mill, right? I heard Firewalk is playing here tonight. They're awesome.
Nope.
Are you kidding?
You should probably just go.
Oh, he almost sounded like Lando there. Let me inside, bit. Oh, I've started a backtalk challenge. Uh-oh, what is this?
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
In backtalk, you use arguments that and insults to get someone to do what you want. Oh, this is where the flowers will come into play. I have to yeah, okay, so... This could be an
don't
interesting
you remember
feature.
What it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Oh, I see. To succeed, pay attention to what your opponent says. Isn't it past my bedtime? That's what it's poking out. Bedtime. Alright, and I can see we got points to see who's winning. No bedtime, your bedtime, or do me a solid. Okay, then pick a comeback that reflects their words back at them. Okay, no, your bedtime doesn't sound right. Like, what about your bedtime? That's just something a 3-year-old would say. No bedtime also almost sounds like it. So, do me a solid, but I'm guessing they want me to choose one of the bedtime ones. But they just both sound stupid to me. I know there's an hourglass in the middle of the screen. I'm sure I won't have time to sit here and ponder later on, but I'm assuming...